So, over the past few weeks or so, I've noticed a lot of hype around these stunt devils that are known for their absurdly high rates of speed while swimming through traffic. And for those of you that are unfamiliar with the term swimming, here's what I'm talking about. I'm not sure if this is like a new trend or if this is what people have been doing for a while, but I've only been seeing content like this pop up in the last couple months. I mean, look at this guy, dude. He's literally steering with his left hand, Instagram live in the right while cutting up in traffic doing 3 digits of speed, dude. Now, the first time that I came across this type of content, I was honestly impressed. Not only are these guys ripping it down the highway with 3 digits on the dash, they're also somehow weaving through traffic while making it all look easy at the same time. Plus, some of these guys are actually wanted fugitives that have successfully evaded the police multiple times. And we're not just talking a few ground units. No. We're talking full-blown helicopters too. Which reminds me of this guy named Carbon Double R Pilot who literally evaded a police helicopter on a sports bike and hit out under this little bridge. Like, bro, these dudes took GTA in real life to a whole new level. The next person I want to show you guys is this guy named Squeeze Benz. He's known for leading the police on multiple chases while taunting them and getting away with it every time. Like, dude was literally doing donuts around this cop in Newark, New Jersey, and then lost him like it was just one or two stars in GTA. Yeah, bro, like my butt cheeks would be clenched right now. And he doesn't even just go around once or twice, bro, does it like 3 times. Look how fast he loses them, dude. They're probably on for a good 10 seconds. He hits the left, and then he's gone. He's gone! But what's even crazier is he runs into more cops right here on the right. Look it, there's 2 cop cars right there, boom. They probably got called out by the last cop, and then he loses them too, bro! Look it, he is gone. He is gone! Squeeze was also featured on a Kick live stream recently that sparked a lot of controversy on the internet. For those living under a rock, basically what happened is Neon, a semi-popular Kick streamer, hopped in the car with Squeeze Benz for a live stream. What ended up happening next was something that you probably could have expected. So they're just driving down the interstate, and then they're cutting up in these middle lanes, and then look. Oh my lord, dude. I don't know if you guys saw, but that Lexus, that white Lexus back there, both the airbags went off. They pulled off on the side. They're in the back now. And Squeeze just...
Oh my fuck.
Squeeze just left, dude. He just left. That's a hit and run. That is literally a hit and run, bro.
What the fuck?
I'm not gonna lie, I've seen a lot of clips of Neon, and I was expecting him to be a lot more freaked out.
Jump me up.
I need to get dropped off, bro.
Anyway.
Jump me up. Yep. They crashed. But not only did they crash, they fled the scene, resulting in Neon and his entourage running down the street after being dropped off by Squeeze. So, within the span of a few minutes or so, not only was a literal crime committed, but it was also live streamed for the whole entire world to see. Like I mentioned earlier in this video, when I first saw this type of content, I honestly thought it was pretty cool, but the more and more I dig into this, the more I get a pit into my stomach watching this shit. Like, look at this guy, Where's 981.
This is actually this dude's first time running from the cops. I found this video from his YouTube channel if you guys want to go check it out. All the videos will be in the description. But as you can see, the white subtitle text is his buddy. He's telling him to chill. And Where's 981 is just trucking right now, pushing 100 miles an hour. They eventually get caught up by some of the boys, man, aka the cops, aka 12, whatever you want to call them. And it led to a pretty crazy situation, man. So back there would have been the cop. Like, dude, we gotta get off the highway. The cop's behind. He's pretty far back, but he's back there. So they get off the frickin' highway, dude. Mind you, this is an off-ramp. Now he's pushing 70, dude. This has got to be like residential, like 35 mile an hour. Like, there's no way the speed limit is going over 40 here, bro. And then he's just running red lights and stuff too, bro. I wonder what car this is. I'm not like a big car guy, so if anyone knows what car this is, let me know in the comments. But yeah, he pretty much just rips it down this side street, parks up, and after this video, we saw a lot of 981 running from the cops. Yeah, this is insane, dude. This is literally GTA in real life. Bro literally said we gotta get the heat off us. Like, this is GTA in real life. What did I say, bro? Oh my gosh, dude. Like, dude, for all I know, it could be me that's driving down the road at midnight looking forward to my next McDonald's trip or something. Imagine, I got my order in mind, I'm almost there, then boom, I get hit by Mr. Squeeze Benz himself. And just like he did in Neon's life, he slides right off. Now I'm just sitting here in my total car, paralyzed, and the worst part, no McDonald's. On a serious note, this type of tomfoolery is so dangerous. And I know there's gonna be people out there defending these guys by saying, oh, Channing, dude, they're professionals. They've been doing this since they were kids. But like, bro, they're driving recklessly like this on public roads, putting myself, you, your mammy, your pappy, and little Timmy in the back in the booster seat. All in danger. It would be a whole different story if these guys were doing this in like an enclosed space in some type of professional setting, but my honest opinion is that we're all humans and we all make errors. Even the most trained professionals mess up, and all it takes is that one accident that could potentially end lives. But it's not my life, it's theirs. I simply wanted to say my piece and also ask you guys what you think about this type of car culture. That's all I got for you guys today. It's been your boy, Chan the Man, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.